offer this just as how I manage the work-life balance thing when I was a squadron commander and when I had these babies. Take it for what it's worth, okay? Work-life balance, that phrase, just, I don't get it. It doesn't, I've never found balance. I'm still looking for it. It doesn't sit well with me. That doesn't mean that it doesn't work for other people. That's cool. Here's how I envision wearing those four hats, right? I got multiple hats. How do I do this? I think of it as like a rheostat, right? A dial, like a volume knob. For the millennials, there used to be these knobs. They were round. You would turn them. And you would turn them, right? You got 100% volume. You got 100% on this on any given day. And I got a dial for each of those, but I only got it to add up to 100, right? So there are times that I'm only 80% fighter squadron commander and maybe 20% mom. Maybe the rest are turned down to zero. This is how I visualize it. And it hit a point where I was failing at juggling these four hats. And I finally put structure to it like a fighter pilot would. I said, here's the deal. Here's how my schedule's gonna go. And I communicated this to my family, to my husband, to my colleagues, and to my leadership. I said, on Mondays, I'm a fighter pilot. I will always fly on Mondays. I told my young scheduler, always schedule me to fly. I'm gonna be a tactical fighter pilot that day. I can't lead fighter pilots if I can't fly the plane, right? Every Monday without fail, I will fly a sortie and I will instruct students that day. 100% fighter pilot. Rheostats come down on everything else. On Wednesdays, I would always stay at work very late. My husband knew I was not coming home for dinner to tuck in the kids on Wednesdays. I was a squadron commander that day. I did performance reports, right? I answered all of the emails. I did all the stuff that my leadership wanted. All of those administrative tasks that take up time, I just dialed it up on Wednesday and everything else came down. On Friday, I dialed up wife. I always went out with my husband. He could expect that I would be there for him. It was something we could look forward to and plan towards. And sometimes it meant just hiding in the bedroom with the nanny outside and like binge watching TV and eating ice cream. And like, that's okay. But that was Friday reserved for my husband. And Saturday and Sunday, mom came all the way up on the rheostat. And I was a mom. My husband knew that. My leadership knew, don't call me on a Saturday night at 10 p.m. to talk about something that can wait till Monday. And I finally had to have the courage when he kept doing it. I said, sir, I'm momming this weekend. Right? I'm mom on Saturdays and Sundays. If this can wait till Monday, you know, that would be great. And you know what? The second you establish those boundaries, people adhere to them. He's like, oh, I didn't know. Oh, okay. But we feel so guilty, right, as women about putting those boundaries out there. We think people are going to overreact and judge us. I have not found that to be true. Decide where those boundaries are, where you're going to wear those different hats, and then communicate it to the people that are impacted by it. I've been given 100% respect every single time. Every single time.